Steel is a really important material in our lives. We literally cannot live without it. It's the backbone for the homes we live in, the buildings we work in, and the transport infrastructure we all depend on. And for HS2, Britain's new low-carbon high-speed railway, it's literally providing the foundations for the largest infrastructure project in Europe. I'm Fran Scott, a neuroscientist by education, but definitely an engineer at heart. And as a non-car owner, I have been following the progress of HS2 rather closely. Finding out how things work is my passion, as well as meeting the people who make extraordinary things happen. So when I started reading into how UK Steel is being used to help build HS2, I was super keen to find out more. Join me on my journey as we explore HS2's steel story. We start here at CELSA Recycling in Rotherham. And CELSA Steel, in partnership with the ROM Group, are the UK's largest manufacturer of steel reinforcement, producing 1.2 million tonnes of steel every year, all made from recycled scrap metal sourced in the UK. And in fact, all of CELSA's steel is fully traceable and 100% recyclable. So these big piles of scrap metal behind me may have already been through several lives. From Sunderland to Mansfield and from Cardiff to here in Rotherham, HS2 is supporting hundreds of jobs in the steel sector. And I can't wait to meet some of the people who help make and shape this valuable commodity. I'll be following this scrap as it gets formed and shaped into rebar, which is basically a strong steel bar that's used to reinforce concrete in building foundations, and all the way to seeing how it's used on an HS2 construction site. Once it is weighed and sorted, the scrap then gets sent on to the next stage of its journey via rail. And this next stage is in Cardiff, and it's a place I've heard so much about, the melt shop. Once the scrap arrives here in Cardiff, it's then tipped, inspected, and checked for quality. It's then ready to be melted down, which is why I am decked out in my specialist PPE, because apparently in the melt shop, it is a rather spectacular show. The melt shop uses an electric arc furnace to process crude steel, which produces 80% less carbon emissions than traditional steel making. It's the most efficient way to produce steel, and it's just one of the ways that CELSA is moving towards net zero. I'm meeting up with CELSA Steel's Gabriella to find out more. Gabriella, what a place! And this is where you give scrap metal a new lease of life, isn't it?
Absolutely. We take scrap metal in from our sites dotted around the UK. All of that is UK sourced scrap metal. We bring it here, we melt it in our electric arc furnace to create molten steel that then gets cast into a billet, and that billet gets re-rolled into a new product. Again, that whole recycle, reuse, giving new life to what was ultimately a waste product.
And that's exactly what's happening right behind us. Wow. Obviously, steel is a worldwide commodity that we all need, but historically, it's not had the best reputation in terms of environmental impact. So how are you doing it differently?
The way we make steel via an electric arc furnace, you know, 98% of our raw material is scrap metal. The way we make it is naturally a very low carbon production route.
And do you look at where the steel that you produce then goes on to be used?
Absolutely. So it's really important that, you know, the steels that we're using, for example, what has ended up in HS2, is actually contributing to the overall decarbonisation of the United Kingdom. You know, the point of HS2 is actually to get more people off roads and using public transport. And that's great. Not only have you got low carbon steel going into a project, but you're also actively encouraging people to utilise public transport. So it's kind of a win-win situation there.
droplets just keep on coming through, each of them just under 1,000 degrees Celsius.
The heat and noise in the melt shop is quite a dazzling experience, but it is fascinating to see the process up close and personal as the molten steel forms into a solid state. And this is how HS2's rebar begins to take shape.
Now here we have our big chunky bits of steel, our billets, and these can be up to 15 meters long, and they're now ready to be rolled into bespoke products. So they're off to the next stop, the Rod and Bar Mill, all by rail.
I'm now just down the road in Cardiff at the Rod and Bar Mill. Our billets have arrived and are about to be reheated to a little over 1,000 degrees Celsius. Reheating makes the steel much softer so it can be shaped quickly and efficiently during the production process, saving on energy. I'm catching up with production manager Stuart, who's going to tell me a bit more about what's going on.
Now, I'm not great with heights, but up here you get a view of just how huge this place is.
Stuart, the speed and efficiency at which the steel just goes through the process is mind-blowing.
From the minute it leaves the furnace door, it'll take about 3 minutes maximum to get to a finished product.
3 minutes? Oh my word. And how many people do you have working here?
In total, within the Cardiff, there's 750 people, but in the Rod and Bar Mill, there's about 158 of multi-skilled and production operators. And most of the operators and craftspeople come from the local catchment area, so we're a big employment entity in Cardiff. It's in their blood that they just want to produce good quality material. So the energy comes from the guys within.
And how do they feel about making products for things like as iconic as, you know, a brand new high-speed railway?
Well, that's part of the interest, you know. If you can do something which makes a difference to millions of people, then, and you can go home, talk about it, go down the pub, talk to your mates about it, it's a little bit different than putting a screw into something which is insignificant.
From their headquarters here in Cardiff, the CELSA Group have already supplied more than 20,000 tonnes of recycled steel to the HS2 project. And with demand set to increase further over the next few years, the figures show us that HS2 is supporting regional growth and employment in a pretty big way.
It's at this point that we have the rebar all cut to length and ready to go to the customer. And that customer is ROM.
I've cooled down from the Cardiff leg of the steel rebar journey, and I'm now at ROM Ltd in Sheffield, one of the leading suppliers of steel reinforcement here in the UK.
Now, get this, the ROM Group are hoping to provide 200,000 tonnes of recycled steel for the London to Birmingham route of HS2. And that's just for this first section, and then there's 20 more years of construction after that. It's quite noisy in here, but what do you do here at ROM?
Yeah, we bring the steel from the steel mill in Cardiff and we cut and bend it to our customers' needs and send it out to the construction site.
And of course, one of those customers is HS2, right?
It is indeed, yeah. We can produce up to about 1,200 tonnes a week here and around 1,000 tonnes a week for HS2.
And do you know which parts of the line it's going to be used at?
Yep, at the minute the majority is going to the northern section, which is in Birmingham, Curzon Street and surrounding areas. Also a lot in and around London, Old Oak Common and more centrally in London.
And that's not just for this year, is it? This is going to be going on for a fair few years.
Yeah, we'd expect it to last, you know, 4 or 5 years.
Oh gosh, they keep you busy.
Having that security of volume coming through certainly gives us confidence going forward.
Where it's going, but you know where it's been.
Yeah, it gives us full traceability. We can follow this right through our system, yeah.
That's a clever little label, isn't it? Now, considering this is steel, I am so impressed with this hydraulic cutting machine. It is slicing through this rebar, literally like it's butter.
all cut or bent to perfect size and ready to go to site. But first, Brian's going to take me to one of ROM's other key sites, ROMTECH. Here at ROMTECH, production tops 800 tons of prefabricated pile cages every month. Pile cages are used in concrete piles and to support the weight of a structure and stabilize the ground around it. They can be up to 10 tons in weight and 2 meters across. The ones here are slightly smaller than that, but they are made from the rebar that we've been following the journey of, all shaped and welded into this incredibly strong cylindrical structure. So you two know each other pretty well.
Yeah, he's my dad.
That's brilliant!
And you both work on these pile cages for HS2, don't you?
Yes, 9 out of 10 jobs that come through the warehouse door are for HS2.
So when you're sat on the train in years to come and it's hurtling through, how will you feel about knowing that you've contributed to that?
I'll be very proud.
It'd be amazing just to be able to tell the family that, look, this is what we've helped accomplish. Our grandchildren are possibly going to be riding the railways that we've helped put in place.
Are you proud of your daughter working with you?
Always. Always.
Is she the best welder here?
No, I am.
The rebar pile cages are now ready to go to site, where they'll play their part in the heart of the foundations of the HS2 project. Next up, Warwickshire. Midlands will be home to HS2's first terminus station. Birmingham Curzon Street will be one of the most environmentally friendly stations in the world, transforming the way people work, live and travel. The Midlands is also home to Burton Green just outside Kenilworth, where HS2 is building a 700 metre green tunnel. This will pass through the local countryside, but it's been designed in such a way that it will integrate with the landscape and beautiful scenery around it. This is where the rebar, or at least some of it, ends up, in the piling cages that strengthen the tunnel walls. And from an engineering point of view, this really is a construction marvel. Just to think that in a few years' time, some of the fastest trains in the world will be whizzing through here, connecting the south with the Midlands, the north, and Scotland. As we heard earlier, all of this is fully traceable. For example, the recently demolished Redcar Mill in the northeast, the steel from that is used across several of HS2 sites. The UK has a long and proud history of steelmaking, and I've seen firsthand how it's as vital today as it was during the Industrial Revolution. However, the really big change is the sustainable approach to its production. And it's fantastic to see companies like HS2, CELSA and ROM at the forefront of this as they strive to help the UK achieve its net zero ambitions. One thing that has not changed though is the detail, the dedication and the skill of the people working within the UK steel industry that make all of this happen. It has been amazing to see their expertise and to hear of the pride that they feel in helping to create a new railway that will serve Britain for decades to come. And that is a story we all want to hear.